Hello everyone, Don LHD here, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Project 64 WWF No Mercy Lucha Underground mod independently on Launchbox. As you can see in this demonstration, I'm launching all of these mods independently of each other in Big Box. Some load quickly and some take longer than others, but the concept itself works. So I'm going to show you how to do that, because the Lucha Underground Arena
is full, sold out. You see all those people over there? Every one of them, money.
So let's get it started. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder, I have my emulators folder and my Launchbox folder. I left the Google Drive link in the description below for everything you're gonna need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download and then download here. Okay, I've downloaded the Project 64 Lucha Underground mod and placed it here on my desktop. What I'm gonna do now is extract the contents of it into the emulators folder. Now I'm gonna launch the emulator for the first time. So I'm gonna go into emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, and the Project 64 EXE here. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is go to options, settings. For right now, we're gonna uncheck on loading ROM go to full screen, just in case you have issues and you need to go in and out of it. And in the directories tab, we're gonna change all these locations here to the directory where your actual mod is. First one is asking for is the plugin directory path. I'm gonna click these three dots here. Once again, the path of my mod is on the desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, and the plugin folder here. Click the OK button once you have it highlighted. Next one is asking for is the autosave folder. So I'm gonna click that three dots again. Desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, save. Click the OK button. Now it's asking for another save folder. We're gonna do that same one again. Three dots, desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64, save again. Click OK. Screenshots folder is next. Three dots, desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64, screenshots, OK. And the last but important folder is the textures folder. Three dots again, desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, plugin folder, and highlight the high-res texture folder here. Click OK, then click Apply, then click OK. Now I'm going to close the emulator to make sure it's saved, and then I'm going to reopen it. Now I'm going to go to Options again, Configure Graphics Plugin. In this section, I'm going to make sure that my resolution matches the resolution that's currently on my PC, which it is. And you can tick around with these settings here and increase or decrease, but just be careful because this may affect performance. I'm going to go here to the Texture Enhancements tab. Then I'm going to click on the Texture Pack tab here. Then I'm going to change these directories to the actual directory where your high-res texture, dump, and cache folders are. So first one is asking for is the texture pack path. I'm gonna click browse. Once again, it's on my desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, plugin folder, and highlight the high-res texture folder here. Click select folder. Next one is asking for is the texture cache path. Click browse here. Inside of the high-res texture, click inside, and the cache folder is here. Click select folder. Last one it's asking for is the texture dump path. I'm gonna click browse, Project 64 Underground folder, plugin folder, texture dump here. Click select folder, and I'm gonna click save enhanced texture cache to hard disk here. Then click OK. Now I'm gonna close the emulator to make sure it saves again and reopen. Now I'm gonna go to options, configure controller plugin. I'm using the Xbox One controller, so I'm going to drop this down arrow here. You're going to select Xbox One for Windows. If you need to configure it, just press on these buttons here and press the corresponding buttons on your controller. If you need to do Player 2, you drop this down arrow here and you do the same for that controller. And make sure you click Controller is plugged in. I'm going to click OK. Now I'm going to go to File. Click Choose ROM Directory. The directory is on the desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground ROMs folder. Click OK. Right click once on the game and click Edit Cheats. And make sure that your LU is checked here. If that's good, just go ahead and close it up. And now you can go ahead and double click here and launch the game. I'm gonna fast forward here, but while it goes through the loading process, first time launching the game, it usually takes about 2 to 3 minutes, but then after that, it's a whole lot quicker. And then once it loads up, test your mod to make sure it plays correctly. And once you've done that, you can go ahead and re-enable the onloading ROM go to full screen box that we checked off earlier. After you've done that, go ahead and close the emulator, and then we can set it up in Launchbox. Okay, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're gonna go up here to the top left corner. We're gonna click on Tools, Manage, Emulators. As you can see, I have my previous three mods from my earlier tutorials. So I'm gonna go ahead and click Add. We're gonna name this mod Project 64 Lucha Underground. Now we're gonna set the path. Once again, my path is on the desktop, arcade, emulators, Project 64 Lucha Underground, and the Project 64 EXE here. Now we're gonna go to associated platforms. Make sure you select Nintendo 64 here. And I'm not going to set it as my default emulator. Now I'm gonna go here to the running script area. And I left the script in the description below that if you require it, you can escape out of the emulator easily by pressing the escape key. I'm gonna paste that here. Now I'm gonna click OK. And then close. Now we're gonna add our game. I'm gonna do the drag and drop method again. I'm gonna go down here to my emulator folder. And inside of the ROMs folder in the emulators folder is your WWF No Mercy mod. Drag that here inside of Launchbox. What type of game files are you importing? Click ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Make sure you select Nintendo 64. Next, manually configure emulator. What emulator would you like to use? Make you select Project 64 Lucha Underground. Next, use the files in the current location. Next, 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 next. I'm going to rename my game to Lucha Underground here. And then click finish. This mod wasn't in the Launchbox game database, so I had to add my own metadata and media. Nevertheless, you have successfully set up, configured, and installed the WWF No Mercy Project 64 mod on Launchbox. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped you out at all, consider dropping a like and subscribing to the channel. I've created other emulator tutorials as well. If you wish to see them, just click on one of the links on the screen. As always, I'm DynLHD. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.